State Departments of Transportation, state DOTs, and other transportation agencies invest in highway infrastructure, including millions of lane miles of pavements. Asphalt pavements are expected to provide durable, smooth, and safe service over their design life. Asphalt mixture sampling is conducted to ensure and understand the quality of the pavement and plays a critical role in producing high-quality road surfaces. Agencies ensure they are spending funds responsibly by using specifications that cover construction practices, such as asphalt mixture sampling, and by generating acceptance procedures for the production of materials and the construction of pavements. The specifications identify the roles and responsibilities of the agency and the contractors. Specifications should include material sampling plans to identify quality characteristics to be measured, and the frequency and location of sampling. Other aspects to be considered are how a sample will be taken, size of the sample, and handling and storage of the sample for testing. In developing their specifications, many agencies will reference standards developed by outside organizations. These organizations could include the American Association of State Highway and Transportation Officials, or AASHTO, ASTM International, or another entity. Multiple standards provide direction on appropriate asphalt sampling for both agencies and contractors. These are voluntary standards not required under federal law. These standards are, however, commonly cited in federal and state construction contracts and may be enforceable when included as part of the contract. Agency acceptance includes sampling and testing, or inspection, to determine the degree of compliance with the contract documents. Properties of asphalt materials and mixtures used for acceptance vary by agency, although several properties are common. Materials tests are typically performed during production. Care must be taken in collecting these material and mixture samples to ensure that the samples are representative of the product in the field. Acceptance testing is used to verify that the product complies with agency-specific requirements. The results of the acceptance tests are used to determine full payment, incentive payment, or disincentive payment per the specifications. Agencies must be able to provide evidence to support proper payment consistent with the applicable federal aid project requirements. Accepting substandard material can reduce service life, ultimately decreasing the overall pavement life cycle. Contractors are responsible for producing and placing material that meets the specifications. Material producers may prefer sampling at the plant as they are in more control of the mixture at that point and can use the information to inform when production plant adjustments are needed. However, the mixture may not represent the finished product in the pavement due to placement practices. With the transfer of control of the material from the production facility to the transportation and laydown operation, additional samples can be at the job site to better represent the final in-place product. Sampling the mixture provides evidence that the contractor is giving the agency an acceptable product that will produce the expected product service life. Proper quality control and process control sampling and testing aid in reducing contractors' risk by helping them ensure that they are consistently producing materials that meet specification requirements. Random sampling is a common approach to represent the entire output over a defined lot or sublot. Using random numbers, each portion of material has an equal probability of being selected for sampling and testing. Random sampling is critical to ensure the integrity of the acceptance decision. Using separate random numbers to identify the location of both contractor QC samples and agency acceptance samples keeps them independent. This approach ultimately supports the acceptance of a quality project that meets agency requirements.
Samples can be taken at various points in the material production and laydown operation, with the location selected based on the test, the agency requirements, and the ultimate use of the sample for quality control and/or acceptance purposes. Safety concerns must always be addressed to support a safe working environment. Spotters, alarms, and eye contact with the plant, truck, paver, and roller operators are examples of essential safety steps. State DOT experts will share their experience with the most commonly used asphalt sampling locations.
Depending on the agency's quality assurance program, sampling at the plant allows the agency to witness and monitor the producer performing quality control testing and immediately possess agency acceptance samples to prevent fraudulent actions such as changing samples and ensure testing competency. Although widely used, sampling from the hauling vehicle at the plant does not capture all of the production and placement variability that can impact the final in-place pavement. Issues such as haul time and segregation from material handling can affect the material's properties, and these changes will not be captured by testing materials sampled at the plant. Drawbacks to sampling at the plant include additional agency personnel are required at the plant and away from the paving site, and potential adverse impacts due to prolonged silo storage and haul complications may not be captured.
Sampling at the point of placement allows the agency to capture and monitor all sources of variability in production and placement. Sampling from a point within the laydown process allows an agency to manage unannounced random sampling with fewer staff, which can reduce the potential for biased materials production. Acceptance sampling of asphalt mixtures after placement allows the agencies to ensure the end product is acceptable instead of relying upon tests of the unplaced mixture, which may not fully reflect the quality of the final constructed pavement. One example of sampling within the laydown process is sampling from the windrow. Material is sampled, following proper procedures, from the windrow after discharge from the truck and prior to transfer into the paver. This approach requires the least amount of rework. Still, it is only viable when a pickup device or material transfer device or material transfer vehicle, MTD or MTV, is used for material transfer into the paver. Other at-the-paver options may include paver augers and a stockpile.
Another option is roadway sampling from the hot mat after the paver and before compaction. When samples are removed from an area that will be subjected to traffic, future pavement distress can be avoided when the area is adequately backfilled and compacted. Material can be directly shoveled from the pave lift, or a plate may be placed in the sampling location immediately prior to paving to prevent contamination from the underlying layer, such as when paving on an unbound aggregate base. When using a plate to sample, a cookie cutter or a flat shovel can be used to limit the impact on the pavement area and to create edges suitable for appropriate patching techniques. For thin lift paving, multiple locations in the sampling area may be needed to yield sufficient material for testing.
Asphalt pavements are a critical component of our highway system. To protect the public's investment and provide a safe and efficient means of travel, agencies must ensure that asphalt materials are of acceptable quality and that asphalt mixtures are constructed to meet specification criteria. The use of appropriate sampling procedures helps support quality materials and construction. No matter the sampling method used, it is imperative for agencies to have detailed sampling procedures to reduce variability in sampling practices. For proper payment, the sample should best represent the quality of material that has been constructed and is in place on the roadway. Following designated standards and sampling practices will help agencies evaluate asphalt mixtures to ensure the roadways perform as expected over the design life.